वही
थैंक
पढ़ो।
यू सो मच गौरव, ऑलवेज अ प्लेजर बीइंग हियर एंड कैन वी हैव द लाइव सर्जरी स्ट्रीमिंग स्टार्टेड, द डेफर्ड लाइव सर्जरी ऑडियो विजुअल, व्हाट डू यू वांट? या सो वी विल बी प्लानिंग फॉर अ लाइव सर्जरी, इज द ऑडियो ऑल्सो देयर? सो
नो
दिस
सर,
इज गोइंग टू बी परफॉर्म्ड एट सेंटर फॉर साइट द्वारका सेंटर एंड वी आर are you running it? And we are planning to do a femtocataract procedure using the Catalyst system, and we will try to put in the new synergy intraocular lens using the signature. Should I do it then? Chal nahi raha.
I think they just need to play it.
Yeah, it is not moving.
I have put five.
Thank you.
I think. Thank you, Namrata. Beautiful. Thank you.
Hello.
Thank you, everyone. Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Yes, Maipal, you are ready?
Yeah.
Hello. Good morning.
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. This is actually a live surgery demonstration that we.
Welcome to Center for Sight. Thank you very much, DOS, for having afforded this opportunity. We have lined up three cases, two of them femtolaser assisted cataract surgery, and one will be an MICS procedure. I'll be doing this lady, 73-year-old lady who has a grade 3 cataract, and we are planning to do a femtolaser assisted cataract surgery along with the implantation of the newly introduced continuous range of vision implant, that is the CRV. So let's first come on to the I'll just tell you something about the new software on the Catalyst machine. So you have the ID details and the name, etc., of the patient that is fed in. What is new that has come in is that you have the K1, K2. So the steep axis, we have still not, this is the COS version 6, in which there is a lot of improvement as regards astigmatism. Earlier when you looked at it, if there was a cyclotorsion, that was not compensated. So what we have to do in the Cassini link up is that, that is like a pentacam, is that you take the steep axis as also you feed the axis here. So the steep axis is 17 degrees which you have fed, and what you do here is wapis karna, we have fed in a capsulotomy which is 5 millimeters, and this is the scanned capsule. You can change it from scanned capsule to pupil or whatever you want, or you can do it manual, but in this case we will be scanning the entire capsular bag and placing the capsulotomy on the center of it. After that we will be trying to break this into four quadrants and then small pieces. So these pieces we have kept at 1500 microns, and this is 500 microns. Now what is important here is that you can, if you want to go on to 6 quadrants or 8 quadrants, you can do that depending upon, or just do the quadrants. In the new software, when you are having repetition rates, that means that when you are cutting and you are having repetition rates, you can skip the central 1 millimeter, and that will reduce the time taken for the nucleotomy significantly. Now the next other important thing that has happened in this is that वापस ले जहाँ पे मेरा था मेरे वाले में कर लो, is that you can rotate the nucleotomy. That means that if my incision is here, I can have the nucleotomy coming right in front of the incision. If my incision is here, I can rotate it this way, which was not there earlier. Now the next thing that we have is on the penetrating keratotomy, that is for the LRI. So Donnerfeld nomogram is being used here, and the Donnerfeld nomogram is being auto calculated by this machine, so you don't have to calculate. So this is the primary axis 180, where I put in my surgically induced astigmatism of 0.37, 0.5, and this will calculate. So you can see here, so this was one diopter of astigmatism. SIA has been put as 0.5, primary is 180, and Donnerfeld scale, because it has moved in, so this has been reduced to 66.67 from the LRI, which used to be earlier as a percentage. Okay. That's it. So And then there is another thing which is a toric IOL alignment. So you can see these marks. So Dr. Rajendra Prasad?
Yes, yes.
So you can,
no, we can see them.
You can have these intrastromal marks. So once you have these steep axes and you know where the lens has to be placed, you can have intrastromal marks in the cornea for doing toric alignment. Understood? So we don't need a Callisto system or for this, because you can have in femto, you can have toric markers and which will remain even post-operatively. So that means that post-operatively also one can see if there is not, if the patient has not regained full vision, then you can see post-operatively whether the lens is aligned in the proper position or not. Okay. So this is the new software. Now you have this patient interface. The patient interface consists of two parts. So this is the applanation which will go, but it does not touch the cornea. It is a liquid optic interface and does not cause any folds on the cornea. That is why this system does not give you any folds in the capsulotomy. So this he will be placing on the undersurface. This is the cassette which goes in for the vacuum. Upar aajo. And this, as you, as I told you, this is for idhar dikho. This is hollow. So the patient interface will come into this and it will not touch the cornea. There will be fluid here. So I ask the patient to open the eyes. Ye light ko dekhe Mataji. Okay. So we apply suction. There's a noise that the machine makes that the suction is full. We put balance salt solution. Bring the patient here and lower the suction. Ab idhar aajo. Idhar aajo bete. Lock karo. Karo. Okay. We lock the bed. Udhar dikha bete. Okay, now we are bringing in udhar dikhao screen. Now you can see that I am bringing this down. There is fluid here. These are air bubbles. I don't like them because this will not allow it to cut. Upar karo. So we just raise this and wipe it out. Okay, now you see these two dots. So these are the markers for 0-180 alignment. So we are aligning it at 0-180. You have the black ring coming in the center of the red ring. Now we have to raise this and get it into the green area. Idhar dikho. We press capture here and then we go to lock. So you have to bring it again to the green area so that there is no friction. Now the fluid is confirmed. Now the rescan is happening. That means that the scanning, 360 degree scanning is happening. This is the front of the cornea that is there. This has to be in the center so that this shows there isn't too much of force, no lateral or vertical force. This is the posterior cornea, anterior lens. You have the angle and the blue is the limbus. This is the posterior. Approve. Zero karo isko. So you can see that this is at 0-180, well aligned. Dabao. This is the steep axis. So you can see if we had the Cassini, this will mark the steep axis and the cyclorotation compensation will happen. But here we did 0-180 and the cyclorotation compensation has happened. Idhar dikhao. We go on to approve. Now you can see 5 millimeters. Everything is fine. This is the LRI. I'm not doing the incisions. So we are going to start. Mataji, ab hilana nahi. Kar. Approve. So I am going to fire the laser. This is the capsulotomy completed in about 1.2 seconds or whatever it was. I didn't see. Now this is the nucleotomy that is happening. So this is 18 seconds more. Total time left is 20 seconds. This includes the time for the LRI. Once you see these air bubbles, it shows that the capsulotomy should be pretty good. And this is the LRI. Okay, and that's complete. So we will take out the patient now. Shift kar lo. ओके इधर आ जाओ डॉक्टर, लाइट जला दो डॉक्टर राजेंद्र प्रसाद, एक बार टी प्लस डाल देना उधर जाकर. या एनी क्वेश्चंस फॉर यू?
द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग विच यू टोल्ड अस लाइक दैट टॉरिक मार्किंग विच दिस मशीन हैज अ न्यू फीचर. This toric marking, like, will it be a radian or what kind?
No, these are two radial marks. Like,
and
you
will it have any effect on the refractive error?
No. They are only intrastromal and they don't have any effect on the refractive error because these are not like an arc. They are this thing, so they're going to be all right and they are in the periphery. The other important thing which you are missing out is the cyclotorsion compensation.
Yeah.
Cassini is like a pentacam. So you do a preoperative pentacam or a topography called Cassini of the patient. The Cassini will identify the steep axis of the cornea. Okay? Now,
yeah.
What happens is if the patient lies down and you are putting an LRI. So if I want the LRI at here and there is a torsion, then LRI will move. So the LRI effect will not be good. So for astigmatism treatment, the LRI has to be at the axis where you have planned. So once you are seeing on the Cassini is marking the steep axis which was there. And if the cyclotorsion is there, it will see that where the steep axis was and it will compensate for this rotation. Do you understand?
Yeah.
So that is the second most important thing. Toric alignment is there. Cassini with the linking up with the topography, you have steep axis for astigmatism management. And then what you had was that the four quadrants or six quadrants were fixed in a particular direction. Now, when I am having an incision or I want them, I can rotate them. That is the other important thing. Plus, the fourth thing is that the time taken for hard cataracts for the amount of energy that is being delivered has been reduced by skipping the central 1 millimeter and the rep rates, and that increases the efficiency of the software. And the time taken is reduced significantly by about 30 to 40%.
Yeah. This nucleus rotation, how it's going to help us?
If you are entering from here, right, and my quadrant is like this, okay, then I have to actually rotate it to go and bury into the quadrant. Do you get it? Jahan
yeah.
Pe meri incision hai na, at the point of the incision, if the quadrant is at another place, then I have to actually bring it in alignment to be able to go in and crack. Do you understand?
Right.
मतलब कि उसके अंदर फिक्स था 0, 180 एंड 90 के ऊपर 90, 270. दैट इज हाउ द फोर क्वाड्रेंट्स वर मेड. बट आई कैन चेंज द क्वाड्रेंट एज पर माय स्टीप एक्सिस और वेयर एवर आई एम डूइंग द दिस थिंग. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ इट बीइंग लाइक दिस, आई कैन हैव द न्यूक्लियस हियर वेयर माय इंसिजन इज. तो जैसे मैं एंटर करूंगा, आई विल बी एबल टू गेट ऑन टू द फोर क्वाड्रेंट. यू डोंट हैव टू एक्चुअली रोटेट इट.
दैट्स राइट.
अंडरस्टूड?
दैट्स गुड. एंड
या चलो, आई विल जस्ट वॉश ऑल्सो. या वील कम इधर ही आ जाओ. नहीं, मैं यहीं वॉश कर लेता हूँ ना. या यस आरपी.
यस
आईपल सर, कैन वी गो टू द सेकंड पार्ट बिकॉज़ वील रन शॉर्ट
ऑफ. सर, हाउ मच एस्टिग्मैटिज्म वी कैन ट्रीट विद दिस?
या आई हैव नो प्रॉब्लम. कैन यू, आई थिंक वी आर रीच्ड देयर. कैन यू जस्ट फॉरवर्ड इट स्लाइटली? वीडियो को थोड़ा सा फॉरवर्ड करो. माइक्रोस्कोप जहां से स्टार्ट होता है इसको छोड़ दो और आगे. हाँ बस ठीक है.
परफेक्ट परफेक्ट.
स्टार्ट कर दो.
नाउ दिस इज द माइक्रोस्कोप व्यू.
इज दैट ओके? आई विल जस्ट सेंटर इट.
इट्स फाइन.
आई विल सेंटर इट. लो, कुर्सी नीचे करो, ये पकड़ो.
बट द फील इज वेरी गुड माइपाल सर. यू हैव गिवन अस अ ट्रू सिमुलेशन ऑफ लाइफ सर्जरी. वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग.
जस्ट लाइफ सर्जरी एक्चुअली.
हाइट बढ़ा दो मैक्सिमम.
इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग, दिस इज व्हेन यू हैड जस्ट रिकवर्ड, इजंट इट?
No, yes.
Yeah. You can see this LRI.
You're right.
17 degree. Light बढ़ाओ यार. Light बढ़ा दो. Okay. You can see this LRI. I'll be making the incision at 180 degrees, and that SIA had been taken into account for the surgery.
Right.
The pupil has come down slightly on me. It was actually small right from the beginning. So I'll be using intracameral phenocaine. Okay, phenocaine is a combination of Xylocard, it is a combination of phenylephrine and tropicamide, tropicacin. Okay? So
right.
So this has been introduced as a good tool for us by, I think, Entod. You're using it, RP?
Yeah, I'm using very routinely now in many of the cases. Rather, like, I don't use the tropicacil plus or something before surgery. I use just the intracameral.
Yeah, this has...
And it really works very well.
Yeah, the only thing is for femto, we'll have to dilate it before, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so let us just start. Is everything, view is all right?
Yeah, view is...
Okay. So I'm going to use the signature machine. No.
Actually, the signature pro that we are using.
Nucleotomy is visible very nicely.
Yeah. Just putting, made the side port.
Gaurav, you also use a lot of phenogen?
You see, it's a free floating capsulotomy.
Yeah.
Can you see that? So I just put phenogen, just will wait for 15-20 seconds. You can see that the pupil, earlier the pupil was at the rim of the capsulotomy, you see it move, right?
No.
No.
You can see the free floating capsulotomy, it's pretty good, and I think one of the important things in the...
Go in first.
Catalyst is that by far majority of the times you get free floating capsulotomy, you really don't have to do. You can actually pull it out with the PECO probe itself.
Okay, so I'll just, you can actually suck out the capsulotomy if you want, but I'll just kind of, you can see that it's free floating. Can you see this?
Yeah.
No. We'll just do a gentle hydro. Actually, it is, you may or may not do it because there is a new, you can see that capsulotomy?
Yeah, very nice.
Okay.
Okay.
That's perfect round. We'll just lift the. Okay. And you can see it's freely because of the pneumodissection. You can see that this
centering is not good. My part centering.
Abhi karta hun. I'll just reduce the magnification also. Yaar, ye koi centering dekh lena. Agar hate to mujhe bata dena. It's okay?
Yeah, no, it's okay. Almost okay.
One second. ठीक है? ये
ठीक
है. ऐसे रखो. Okay?
Now it's fine, yeah.
Okay. लाओ मुझे फेंको दो. This is a 20 gauge needle. What are the settings? Okay, so it's 370 vacuum, 40 power, white star, and you have 34 as the aspiration, okay? So this is the bent Kelman tip. Just remove this bit, isko aise rakho. Center dekh lena tu. Visco dal diya cornea. Dalo. So I use a chopper which is a sharp cutting and inside cutting. I think RP has done a wonderful job by making his chopper for hard cataracts or otherwise also. So you can see that going in, you can see how easy it is. Can you see?
Yeah.
It's already pre-chopped. You really don't need any energy. Rotation is also good. Okay, go to quadrant.
Good.
So we are increasing the vacuum now on quadrant mode. Kitni setting hai?
420
vacuum. So it's about 425 vacuum.
45
power. 45 power. Aspiration? 38. Okay, cornea wet kar. So you can see this. How easily the nucleus gets devoured. It was a grade 3 cataract. Again, you can see we can go here and you can see the separation. Even though the pupil is small, I am restricting myself to the central part of the pupil. And you can see that the surge control is very good with the Signature Pro. And ठीक है हैप्पी ओके सो हाउ मच इज द पावर दैट वी हैव यूज्ड एनर्जी ईपीटी क्या है कोई ईपीटी बता दो यार 2.5 seconds please that is the EPT we have used and you can see a good axis the right. the only thing here is that you have to go below the axis to do the aspiration because the cortex has got cleaved okay because of the laser ye cornea ko kata do upar se एक मिनट लोड मत करना वो लेंस मेरे को दिखाना होगा मेरे को लेंस दिखाना होगा लोड मत करना
इट्स गोइंग आउट ऑफ सेंटर यस नाउ इट्स फाइन गुड
You can use a bi-manual irrigation aspiration if you want, but generally we use a coaxial one. Bend.
Visco dena.
Normally, if you want, you have some issue at 12 o'clock. It's better to always inflate the bag as I am doing, so that you are not critically close to the posterior capsule, and then go back again and remove the cortex, as you can see here. It's much easier with a inflated bag to do 12 o'clock. A bi-manual may be better.
Nepal sir, one day I'll convince you to switch to bi-manual like you've convinced me for so many other things that I've started doing.
Okay. Fine. So basically, I think the exquisite control that I have with coaxial is perfect. I can always, I've done it, but somehow anyway, this is the 12 o'clock that we are kind of working at. The important thing here is to be, again, you can see so that.
Normally, see, whenever there is a difficulty in the 12 o'clock or otherwise, you just put some viscoelastic so that the chamber is deepened. Now you can again, with that, the pupil also dilates slightly. And you can see that I am able to visualize the cortex now better. And I'm able to get it out.
Bimanual port helps very well in such situation.
But I'm not actually. I don't use too much of a bimanual.
Can we, people, sir? Can you ask audiovisual to switch off the audio, and we can have some of the discussion? That will be more meaningful, I think.
Okay, that's fine. I have no problem. Have they stopped it? इसको चलने दो भैया
वीडियो वीडियो चलने दीजिए ऑडियो ऑफ कर
दीजिए एंटायर थिंग दैट्स नॉट अ प्रॉब्लम
ओके सो बेसिकली नाउ वी विल बी गोइंग इन फॉर द सीआरवी लेंस व्हिच इज द कंटीन्यूअस रेंज ऑफ विजन लेंस व्हिच इज द सिनर्जी एंड दिस इज द इट इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ अ ट्राइफोकल एंड एन ईडॉफ लेंस सो दिस इज द LRI दैट हैड बीन मेड बिकॉज द पेशेंट हैड अ स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ एस्टिगमेटिज्म एंड वी आर ओपनिंग द LRI आई नॉर्मली डू अ फुल थिकनेस LRI यू कैन सी हियर रादर देन जस्ट एन इंट्रास्ट्रोमल एंड यू कैन सी दैट दिस हैज बीन ओपनड इन केस यू डूइंग एन इंट्रास्ट्रोमल यू हैव लेस ऑफ इरिटेशन for the patient, but the effect is slightly less. So full penetrating LRI is what I normally do. Now this CRV lens, which is the Synergy lens, has a slight tint in it. It's not actually yellow, but it blocks the UV light, but not the blue light. Now you can see the rings in this CRV lens. There is the central target. And then you have the trifocal lens, which is going on along into the body of the lens. What is important in this is that it is exactly packed the same way as the Technis that we are used to. And the Technis platform, the folder, unfolder is the same system which is there. And you can push it from a 2.8 millimeter or a 2.6 millimeter incision that you can easily. What is important in this is that it is, apart from being trifocality, which gives you good distance, intermediate and near vision, it also has the asphericity that we are aware of in the Technis lens. But in addition, it has the achromaticity. That means that the light disturbance that you have, the chromatic abrasion that you have normally, is also taken care of. So here you can see it is going in very smoothly, gently, does not open with a jerk, and does not take ages to open either. So I think it is a good match. The material is time tested. We have all used it in our patients, in the VIP patients, and you can see it will go and sit very well into the bag. So the Synergy lens has very minimum. So that's the lens, as you can see, that's the trifocality with the EDOF. The Synergy lens of the close to, I would say now 50 eyes that I have done, there isn't any significant complaint of dysphotopsia. The reading ability at 33 centimeters is good, and the intermediate vision is also good. Plus what is claimed, though I haven't personally run these studies, is that the night vision or the contrast diminution in low contrast is not there. So this is basically, now we'll remove the viscoelastic. The other problem with this lens just now, a problem, or I think it's just a waiting time, that we still don't have the toric variety of the Synergy or the CRV lens. And this is pretty much the end of the surgery. The viscoelastic will be taken out and we will hydrate the wound. I think, Gaurav, we can have the discussion now.
Yes, sir. We'll have a quick discussion. Although I feel that, you know, the second surgery is also a Synergy, and maybe we can have the discussion right after the second surgery. Is that right, Dr. Ramamurthy? Are you also planning to? That's what the list I got, that you're also in Synergy.
Exactly the same thing.
Okay, so I think you can show your video, and then we can have a discussion on Synergy and Femto both, because both of you are probably showing the same.
Can you stop this video? Audio visual.